tonight on the 8 out of 10 Cats Christmas Special. Dashing through the snow, it's Tom Allen. Last Christmas, he gave you his tart. It's Liam Charles. And Rob Becket, their team captain. And facing them tonight, she's a Christmas cracker. It's Scarlett Moffatt. Maisie, it's cold outside. It's Maisie Adams. And Katherine Ryan, their team captain. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to the 8 out of 10 Cats Christmas Special, a show about opinion polls, surveys, statistics, and, of course, Christmas. Did you know 6% of Brits buy advent calendars containing alcoholic drinks? But I don't need a calendar to remind me to drink at Christmas. I just look at my family. 16% of grandmothers say Christmas is the only time of year they get drunk and let their hair down. So it's not just Santa that comes but once a year, right, Grandad? For Santa to deliver presents to all the children in the world in one night, he'd have to visit 832 homes per second. Yeah, but Mum says he's magic and he can stop time. So put that in your stupid pocket, stupid face. And 15% of Brits give their bin men a festive tip. Not me. I put the whole thing in. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. It's our palace job to guess the British public's top three favourite things about the festive season. Rob's team, what do people love about the festive season?
Oh, it's got to be the dinner, innit? I tell you what's a revelation I had last year, turkey crown. Much easier. Easier to carve it up, tastier. I do feel it's a bit cruel breeding them without bones, but...
What is it, Rob?
Never had a turkey crown.
Ah, what is it?
It's just like no arms or legs on it.
What, do you breed them like that? You're making that up.
That is just the middle bit. Like, it's just the top of it. So
yeah,
you don't
but
have to
it has
all
had
the
legs at some point, though.
Yeah. Yeah, but they're cut off.
Hasn't it?
Yeah.
This is real turkey, but they just take the delicious bit and just sell you that. Tom, what do you think?
I find it disgusting. Too much. People want to have a turkey inside a cow, inside a pig. What's that called? A turducken. And there's too much on the plate. You put meat and you put potatoes and then you put parsnips and carrots. What's a parsnip? It's just a photocopy of a carrot.
There are a lot of sick dishes, Tom. You're absolutely right. Like that turducken, when the animals finally rise up against us, the people who ate turducken will be, like, looked upon as Nazi scientists.
Can we not just all agree turkey is shit?
Like, it is.
Any other time of year, if you went round someone's house for a roast and they were like, we're doing roast turkey, you go, I'll get my coat.
Oh, my God, you've never had a turkey dinosaur before, have you?
What's a turkey dinosaur?
A turkey dinosaur? Are you joking?
Is that what they do with the legs that they take off the turkey crown?
Little turkey dinosaurs. You can get turkey dinosaurs, turkey unicorns.
I've had that.
Yeah.
You can get turkey unicorns.
Oh, honestly, they taste sensational.
Are
like
you currently
nugget?
Doing an advert for Iceland? And I'm here right now.
Yeah, they'd be like breaded turkey, but in the shape of dinosaurs and unicorns. So they're actually educational as well, because you're learning about creatures.
Because you're learning about dinosaurs and unicorns.
Because,
yeah, I remember when the unicorns died out when they got hit by that meteorite.
Tell you what's underrated and what saves any Christmas dinner is gravy.
Yeah.
Because if you don't have good gravy, you ain't got a good dinner. Like, if it's dry turkey, stick a bit of gravy on it.
Yeah.
All the Brussels are overdone, stick a bit of gravy on it. All your slippers don't fit, stick a bit of gravy.
I'm obsessed by the cranberry sauce. Just the idea that you go, what are we having, turkey? Like me, oh, we should probably put some jam on that, shouldn't we?
Yeah. But, and the mango chutney. That's a secret jam, isn't it?
Yeah, that's...
That's a good one.
That ain't a chutney, that's a jam all day long, isn't it?
The strange world of Rob Becket. Was 9/11 an inside job? Is mango chutney a secret jam?
Yeah. You two work in bacon. Is it a jam?
Well, we don't make mango jam.
You do, but in your own time.
Thank you. I meant my man go.
Jam.
And that's my jam.
Liam, you are a baking expert. Do you cook at Christmas? Do you
know what I didn't last year? I couldn't be bothered. I'm not gonna lie.
You couldn't be bothered?
No.
Because you hate the little baby Jesus?
I love baby Jesus.
Well, if you love baby Jesus, cook a dinner.
I just decided to
cook. Who did the cooking?
My nan. My nan always does it. She doesn't want anyone in the kitchen, so, Liam, get out of the kitchen!
There'll be a day when you have to take over, though.
Did you just bring up his grandma's death?
No, I'm like, I saw that 5 years before, when she keeps chopping the potatoes up. Fucking hell.
Katherine, what do you think?
You should all be in prison for bread sauce.
Yes, please. I agree.
Bread sauce is amazing. Why? Oh, I love
it. It's porridge for pussies, Jim.
What the hell is bread sauce? What? I've never heard of that.
You've never heard of bread sauce?
Do you just put sauce on bread?
No.
Scarlett, it's this thrush that they pour all over their dinner.
Horseradish?
No. It's bread sauce.
It doesn't matter how many times you keep repeating, I've never heard of it. You know what it is?
You also need to pick a team, because you can't have a Christmas dinner and have gravy on and bread sauce. Like, it's one or the...
And cranberry.
And yeah,
some
literally.
People...
Are you saying I can't have all three?
Yeah, that's just...
Because, to be honest with you, I don't need anything else.
I
could leave the turkey and the potatoes and just have the sides.
Do you cook? Do you do the cooking?
What? Yeah, sure I do. I've just made three people unemployed. You happy now?
Yeah. Do you have someone for each sauce? Cranberry, come here.
Maisie, what do you think?
My brother started going out with a vegetarian, and so he's only vegetarian when she's around. Mm. So come Christmas Day, he was like, oh, yeah, pass us the nut roast. And we were like, you were literally, like, balls deep in pigs in blankets. Weird thing to say about your brother. But
that's fair enough, though, because if they're having unprotected sex, then she's getting, like, meat particles in
Catherine,
her back.
Stop, stop.
Like, if she swallows after she...
Stop!
Hey, that's a good point. Sperm's not vegan, right? Now, the best thing about Christmas food is the leftovers, in my opinion. And some people combine the leftovers in very unusual ways. I've got some examples for you. So, first off, I've got a turkey sandwich, and it's made with brandy butter. Please, enjoy.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. Turkey with custard on it.
No.
Absolutely disgusting.
That's mango jam.
I mean,
well, you're really not happy about that.
Got that hit of, like, what? Cognac afterwards.
Oh, Scarlett, I'm pretty sure you've eaten a kangaroo anus in the jungle,
I did. But you want to say, I ate a few animals' dicks, but I'd rather eat them than this. That's awful.
Maisie loves them. Ooh.
Maisie, you're into it?
Mm, yeah, lovely.
Are you a fan, Catherine?
I like butter, and if it has alcohol in it, I like alcohol.
So... You're just licking the butter off the bread? OK.
Yeah.
I love it if you got, later on, you got pulled out of the... At the police and found a breathalyzer. I drunk. Well, I licked three loaves of bread.
Okay, so next up, frosted Lucky Charms with ice cold Baileys. So just pour the Baileys
that
in.
Nice.
This is more than nice. If you want type 3 diabetes, this is the way.
Oh my God. I'm gonna do the whole bottle. The whole bottle in, Jim. No, it's not. No, it's not. It's gonna go on the desk.
Oh.
Yes!
Right.
Mm,
that's a big
yes.
Big
is
yes.
It? How good?
We like it.
Oh, much Baileys.
Yeah, it's clearly too much Baileys.
What have you done? Why have you? Why have you?
I've ruined it.
Well, have you ruined it? You've got quite a lot on your chin.
You said that last night.
How much of you? Oh, yeah, you.
I forgot we were filming for a bit there. I've been watching you.
Would you?
I felt like I was watching the telly then. I genuinely forgot I was even on the telly.
I'm having a bit of that. It's
unbelievable.
The bee is so strong.
So strong.
Like it?
Good, right?
Fuck me.
Again.
That's like an instant headache, but it's amazing. Okay. All right, let's take a look and see if Christmas dinner's up there. Yes, it's Christmas dinner! I like Christmas dinner with just the right amount of Brussels sprouts. None Brussels sprouts. My favourite bit of Christmas dinner is that bit at the end when everyone fucks off back to their own houses. Katherine's team, what do you think people love about the festive season?
They're stupid families. Spending time with family, you know, getting away from the hustle and bustle of it all and actually spending quality time with the people who messed you up. You turn off a lot of the devices and you play board games. The trouble is you can't really bond with them over the board games the way we once could. Young kids now are kind of offended by loads of the... My daughter won't play Mousetrap on account of the animal rights. When I won a beauty pageant in Monopoly, she said I was part of the problem.
Even the games at Christmas, though, you don't realise how not normal some of your games are until you spend Christmas, like, elsewhere.
Tell me more.
The main game we played at Christmas growing up was Fishwaft.
Sorry?
And I didn't realise until the age of 25 that not many other people play Fishwaft.
What are the rules of Fishwaft again?
So this was a game that was created by my great auntie Mary, and what you do is cut the shape of a fish out of the newspaper, and then in teams you would have to try and waft your fish to the other side of the room the quickest. Time used to fly by up north.
Oh, Fishwaft.
Fishwaft, yeah.
What, you played that?
No, no one's fucking played that.
Fishwaft
is so much fun. You get really into it, and there's a technique and everything.
Is it better to have a sturdier magazine?
Yeah. What you want is a sturdier magazine.
Zoo magazine from when I was 15.
Rigid.
Yeah.
Rigid. Yeah.
I imagine there would be a fishy waft off that.
The thing about spending time with families, it's supposed to be all about kids, isn't it? Yeah. And I remember when I was a kid, my favourite bit of Christmas was always the nativity plays.
Oh.
I loved being in a nativity. I loved it. I was brilliant. And Joseph was my favourite one. And
so you played Joseph?
Yes.
Oh, that's
and
not then,
and they sassed
me back. I think
it's
quite a good casting, not the real dad.
Yeah, exactly. They sassed me back and went, oh, yeah, not your baby. Yeah, no shit, Sherlock.
You know what? Nativity plays are, like, quite a sore subject in our family because the nativity play is the only proper lie I've ever told my mum and dad.
What lie did you tell them?
Because I wanted them to be proud of us, right? And every year, I always just got either angel number two or angel number three. And when I was 10 in year six, I was like, this is my final year of becoming Mary. And Jill got it, and she got it already three times as well. I was like, fucking bitch. So then I told my mum and dad that I got the role of Mary. And my dad, like, learnt the lines with me. And my mum dyed the blanket blue. And then they went the nativity and I was the only fucking angel stood in a blue costume.
Passive aggressive as well to come dressed as the part you wanted.
And my mum and dad were like, why did you lie? And I said, I just wanted just to be proud of them.
They're not proud of you and they never will be because you're a liar.
Oh, no.
Well, let's have a look at spending time with the family. It's up there. Yes, it's spending time with family. I like Trivial Pursuit because I always get the questions right. Shall we play Trivial Pursuit? No. Correct. That's it for part one. See you after the break. Welcome back to the 8 out of 10 Cats Christmas special, where we're still trying to guess the British public's top three favourite things about the festive season. Right, fingers on buzzers, one more to get. Catherine's team.
I think they really like presents, Jimmy. It's very difficult to buy presents for people because you don't want to buy them stuff that kills the planet. Equally, you don't want to buy them stuff that was made by Taiwanese children's little hands. But all the cool presents do both.
What's the best thing you got, Scarlett? What's the best present you've ever had?
Just happiness.
Oh.
No, I'm only joking. I mean, that is good as well, but genuinely, I prefer given presents.
Once, when I was a teenager, one of the neighbours bought me a handbag. I thought I was doing a really good job of hiding the fact that I was gay, and then I got given a clutch bag, like I was going to a dinner dance.
By one of the neighbours?
Yeah.
What did you do with it?
Well, I use it to put my hand cream in.
So, well, what about you, Liam?
Do you know, like, those link sets?
Oh,
every single one from my aunties, I have, like, the whole collection of links. Africa, Excite, Chocolate, Angels.
Voodoo, Java.
Yeah, so I have, like, the whole catalogue of
links. So they gave you, like, deodorant for 10 years in a row and you never got the message?
Secret Santa is hard. I used to work in retail. What's really good is when people come in and buy their Secret Santa and then the person who has been gifted it obviously hates it and comes back and is like, I just don't really like it. How much did they spend? Just find out how much to go in store. And telling that person spent £4.99 on their Secret Santa.
I used to work in an office when I first moved to the UK, and for the Secret Santa, I just gave the man in my office, I didn't really know him, just a framed headshot of myself. And I signed it with kisses, and I just did it to watch him open it and be like...
Did he get a divorce?
No, he was just really creeped out.
See, sexual harassment can be fun if a girl does it.
It's hard, though, buying presents, like, as adults. My wife's done it, we've done this new thing this year where it's like, she said to me, is there anything that you never got that you wanted when you was a kid? And maybe we could do that like a nostalgia present. So this year, hopefully I'm going to get Scale Electrics or Wanked Off Behind the Chip Shop.
What was the specific behind the chip shop kink?
I wasn't drawn there for the chip shop. It was more the wanking off, but it just happened that was the place to go.
But why not? Two birds with one stone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chips, a wank. It
Perfect.
Sounds like a lovely Friday.
Or you have to have the wank before the chips, because you don't want some sort of salt and vinegar emergency.
That is disgusting.
Tell you what, write that down, kids. Write that down.
I tell you what's difficult about Christmas is all the, like, the throwaway, like, recycling and the single-use plastic and all stuff like that. So you feel a bit guilty. So what I do is now I get it all in one big black bin liner and just throw it to Thames, because there's nothing in there. There's no turtles or whales or dolphins. And if a whale is stupid enough to swim up through Gravesend, you know, it's asking for it.
I don't like all this business of gift receipts either. You know, if I buy someone a gift, I'm not going to go, oh, here's a receipt so you can take it back. I've bought you a banana. Enjoy it.
It sounds like what you've done is re-gifted some stuff. You don't have the receipt.
Yeah.
Have you never re-gifted anything?
I did take some wine round to your house once.
Who gave you that then?
You did. Wine. Who knows what wine looks like? Rob loves so good wine, especially at this time of year. Yeah. And
what are you going to say?
Does he?
Yes, he does.
You've got to say something.
And Rob has a hot tub, and it doesn't matter what time of the year it is.
Yeah.
If you go around to Rob's house as a guest, you have to go in the fucking hot tub. You invite people round, and then within 3 seconds of them being there, up. Oh, I've got some swimming shorts. Let's go in the hot tub. Oh, I'm just having some eggnog. Okay. And so you have to go in the hot tub and sit there.
You like that hot tub.
I do like that
hot
tub.
And you bring your own trunk sometimes as well.
No, I do not. I've always worn your ones.
Let's not have this argument here.
Nice. And it's got a telly in the hot tub. Tell them.
Tell them. Come on, Mr. Showbiz. Come on, Mr. Showbiz. Tell me about the hot tub in the garden.
I've got a telly you can see from the hot tub.
No, because it's right there. Look, I don't mean to be unkind, but it's common. The postman rings Rob's door. He's like, oh, great, come into the hot tub.
No, because I knew him from school. That's why he gets
it. I feel like mums are the Christmas makers in a lot of homes. And when my parents got divorced, my dad didn't even try. Like, he would drive us to the mall and then give us each money. He would stay in the car. My sisters and I would have to go to the mall and buy our own things that we wanted for Christmas, then get back in the car, go to his flat, wrap those presents, put them under the tree, and then wait for a month and then reopen them at Christmas. But then we got wise to it. And when you're a kid, you know, you have no money and you want your stuff early. So we started buying things, swapping them out for old things, wrapping the old shit, leaving that under the tree, and, like, wearing the new clothes and playing with the new toys. Fuck you, Dad.
Yeah, she's also slept with a lot of random dudes.
Merry Christmas, bitch, I fucked everyone.
Well, I can tell you, Christmas presents are not up there, but this year I'm going to get my girlfriend a terminally ill puppy. That way, she gets a dog, but it is just for Christmas.
She's going to die anyway!
12% of mums start their Christmas shopping in January, but Christmas was in December. You missed it. Stupid mums. Stupid mums. Speaking of presents, I've actually got Christmas gifts for all of you. Rob, I got you a double slanket.
I mean, hope you'll normally enjoy this. You open it and find out. Oh, what's it gonna be?
Yeah, it's a double slanket, so you can sit
on
the sofa.
When we get out of the hot tub, we can put this on.
Oh, this is gonna be perfect.
It's got one arm for both of you in the middle, so you can hold hands.
The middle arm?
Yeah, hands in the
middle. It's like it's been made for a cow.
Milk me?
We're not round the back of the
chip shop now, Rob.
Lovely.
Oh, this is... I feel so relaxed.
This is so... I'm just going to go for a piss.
Such a lovely gift. Yeah. Thank you, Jimmy.
Bye, Tom.
Bye.
Okay, I got you a gift as well, Tom. Do you want to take a seat?
Oh, I get a gift?
You... Oh, so I have to share mine with him?
Well, you could share it with whoever you like. The postman, whoever's come round to use the hot tub.
Oh, I think you'll enjoy
this?
It.
What's this?
It's a box.
I know.
It's a clutch bag.
It's like a clutch bag. Oh, how kind. A tie?
It's a tie, but it's got a flask in it and booze.
Oh, finally, something I want.
Wow.
Wow, what a lovely gift.
The other bit, the smaller end, is a little flask, and you've got a little... and you can just...
Oh, my God.
You can suck stuff out of it.
You getting it?
Is it just bread sauce?
The thing is, if it's designed to be like a subtle way of drinking... No one noticed. Wait a second.
Is Tom an alcoholic? I don't think so.
What do you mean you never touch the stuff?
Okay, Liam, I got you a little something.
Nice one.
Now, I know you love baking, so yeah. I got you a baking-related gift.
Let's have a look. Cheers.
Stop telling him.
You gonna be all right, Liam?
What is it?
For making cookies.
Oh!
I made some earlier.
Yeah!
You've got cookies, and then you can put spunk on it with icing.
Wow! Oh,
that's lovely, isn't it?
That's lovely, Jimmy.
It's a lovely spunky cock. Tom, do you want to do some piping?
What?
There you go.
That stuff will be a mess when it's wet. No! What are you gonna do?
Oh, my God.
I can't even look at it. I know
that you put a horse part in your mouth.
Now what do you do?
Oh, no!
Guys, who swallows?
At least we know the answer. 15 hot tubs, now I know.
Oh, Katherine, we got you a little something.
OK.
Open it, try and guess.
It's a mouse! Oh, it's a Canadian hat.
Yeah.
The moose's like eyes, they
it
just
does look
so
like a novelty hijab. Scarlett, I've got a gift for you.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is a great gift.
Do I get
Oh, it's a big old box, though, isn't it? Thank you. What the hell is this?
Just pop that on.
Oh, I like that.
It's a lovely gift, Jimmy. One,
yeah. It's nice, isn't it? You don't have to share it with someone else.
Mine.
Pull those up.
Yeah.
That's
lovely stuff. I like that.
Is that nice? That's great. And then...
If you've just tuned in, I don't know. Now, Maisie, I know a little bit about your past.
Oh, hello.
And I know that when you were at college, you had a CV with your acting skills on it. And one of your acting skills... Well, I'll give you the gift. I'm not going to tell you what it is. You can just unwrap it.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Wow.
Can you tell what it is yet?
That impression's aged well. Basically, I did a drama degree and I thought, acting's hard. I should do something that I can put on my acting CV that will really set me apart from the other people in the audition room. So I chose to learn to unicycle.
Oh, like Meryl Streep.
What is that, then? The back of a bike?
How dare you say that about whichever one of the three you're talking about?
I should point out, I've not done this, like, since uni.
Yeah, I've had a lot of girls say that to me. OK. Maisie Adam, everyone. Circus Girls.
Wow.
Welcome back to 8 out of 10 Cats, where we're still trying to guess the British public's top three favourite things about the festive season. OK, fingers on buzzers. Go on.
Christmas, like, films, Christmas... Christmas adverts.
All the TV programming, one. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like, you know that John Lewis ad?
Mm.
It's very cute, but, like, and it's cute every year, but does it work? Like, I've never got to the end of one and, yeah, been emotional, but been like, oh, I'm really going to go buy a toaster. Like...
I gave up on the John Lewis one when they had that pedo on the moon.
I don't know if that was meant to be the message of that.
Yeah, well, that's what I took from it.
Say what you will, pedo on the moon really touched me.
Explain a lot.
I like the World War One advert where the troops met in no man's land. That was so profound. I bought kitchen towel from Sam.
I tell you what I don't like to watch at Christmas.
Go on.
Is I will. Is is that dreadful film, The Snowman? You know, like, in America, lovely. In America, they get, like, all those, like, jazzy children's cartoons as kids, you know, really upbeat about animals singing and laughing. What do we get? The Snowman, which is about a little boy who makes friends with a snowman, and they go on an adventure, and then he says, see you later. The next morning, he wakes up, and his friend is dead. He's melted to death, and all that's left of him is his nose. His weird character.
Well, the point of the story is that, like, he still had good moments with him.
Yeah.
But sometimes all good things must come to an end.
And he's still got a carrot.
Yeah. It wasn't all doom and gloom.
They sanitize things for America because we have Frosty the Snowman.
Right.
And he melts and everyone's sad, but then he comes back.
Yeah.
Because the boy believes in Christmas.
Oh, that's what that's all about.
Frosty.
Whereas we had, like, he won't be back anymore because he's dead.
And because of global warming, we'll never have snow ever again.
Well, many people are searching for the meaning of Christmas, and I think this druid being interviewed on a daytime show has really nailed it.
Celtic tradition, Andy. What's mistletoe from them?
Well, mistletoe was regarded by the druids as a very, very sacred plant because it grew between heaven and earth. It didn't actually have contact with the ground because it grows as a parasite on trees. Oh. And so it's actually meant... The white berries are meant to signify the divine semen, and the red berries of the holly were meant to represent the menstrual blood of Mother Earth, and the two were brought into the home at Christmas time.
Ooh.
As a fertility rite to ensure a bountiful harvest 9 months later.
Huh? Oh, I see. So that's how that came. Well, didn't expect that answer.
I can't believe that's the story behind...
It is not the divine semen. There's no story about divine semen.
Well, you know, at weddings, the confetti.
No. Yeah.
That's what that represents. It's a medieval tradition.
What, it's like a paper bukkake?
Yes. It's a paper bukkake for the bride.
I forgot where I was then, and now I remember Mum and Dad will watch this.
Google paper bukkake.
Wait till you get married and your dad starts throwing it on your head.
Right, let's see if it's up there. Yes, it's Christmas TV and film. I love Christmas TV. There's nothing better than sitting down to watch a film you've seen countless times before with people you can no longer stand. So those were the nation's favourite things about the festive season, but also on the list, decorations. We've got a Christmas tree in our office, but we're very sensitive to other faiths, so we've had it circumcised and put it in a burqa. Shopping. I tried to buy a penis enlargement kit in the Boxing Day sales, but it all went wrong and I ended up getting 50% off. New Year's Eve. I love New Year's Eve, drinking excessively, vomiting everywhere, and then getting a bit handsy in a dark corner. Next year, I must invite people around. And last Christmas, we had loads of carolers outside our house. They had flaming torches and were singing a carol I'd never heard before, something about pedos out, pedos out. It was absolutely delightful. So at the end of all that, Rob's team have 1 point, Catherine's team have 2 points. Time now for our musical round. It's Christmas, why not? Now, Christmas is a time when you can gather round and watch Mum play Christmas music on her bell suit. You know, bell suit. No? Take a look at this astonishing clip.
Oh,
this?
What are we...
Yeah.
My favourite bit is quite early on when the dog gets up and fucks off board. Yeah. Now, you've all got your bell suits on, so come and join me in the performance area. Oh, this is going to be quality. Oh, yeah. I've given each team a tune to play on the bells. The team who does the best wins the points.
OK. Rob, let's warm this up, lads.
Ian, are you ready? Because you look fabulous.
I think I look like Anne Boleyn with this head. Can I go have a go on your C sharp?
Go on, Bill.
OK, take it away, Rob's team.
B, B. B.
What song is this?
E. Hello.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Can someone get the door?
All right.
It's so much
right.
Blue.
All right, I fucking get that one right then.
It was going right. So well.
It was going so well, you stupid prick.
I'm making this look silly.
I'm doing this on Songs of Praise.
Here we go.
Ready?
Yeah. I feel like I'm in the Big Brother house. It doesn't even exist anymore. Why? At what point in the Big Brother house did they do campanology? This is called campanology, by the way. Did you know that?
Only when you're doing it.
Shut up.
Come on, here we go.
It's a here we go. Just please.
All right.
For the love of God, don't ruin Christmas.
Right, ready?
Yeah. C, bruv.
And again. An A.
Katherine, Maisie, Scarlett, take it away. Back to our 10 Cats Christmas special, and the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top New Year's resolution.
Oh. People always make resolutions to be better and to be fitter, and they always fall short. So I think I would make the resolution to just really let myself go.
I might start smoking.
Yeah.
Give me something to quit next year.
Yeah. Did you make any resolutions last year, Liam?
Being like completely honest, so if I don't like someone, I'll tell them I don't like them.
Oh, yeah.
Jeez.
Go around the room. Start with Tom.
What do you think of it?
I love Tom.
Okay.
You on the other hand, different story. I'm joking.
Still angry about the virgin joke from last time.
Mate, I've lost my virginity now.
Yes.
How was Mary Berry?
It was actually proof, thank you very much.
Did you leave her with a soggy bottom?
Oh, God.
Maybe.
Nice. I'm just going to slam this in for 40 minutes.
Oh, my God.
Rob, how do you like to spend New Year's Eve? Because I like to naked human bowl.
Yeah.
What's that?
Why is everyone looking at me weird? Naked human bowling. Take a look.
What does he mean with the ball?
No! Oh, I nearly got it.
Crazy. Men are crazy. Like, we get really worked up over a group WhatsApp, you know, thread. You know, we do our things, fine. But naked bowling, you could see straight through that man.
You know what you gotta remember about that? He's probably got a wife. He's gonna have got home smelling of fairy liquid. She's gonna go, what happened? Oh, nothing, love, just a laugh.
Quite tight. He's gonna say, honey, I got a fairy liquid enema as I slid across the floor of the rugby club, and then I shot myself at the Christmas party.
She's gonna go, not again, Dave.
Okay, back to resolutions. Tom, have you got a resolution for this year?
Yes, I really wanna get a girlfriend. Just haven't met the right woman, but maybe this year I will.
Me.
Oh, it might be you, Katherine.
Thank you. I think it would be an excellent couple.
I think we would too.
I wouldn't make you fuck me at all.
Great. That's the woman I'm looking for.
I was born to be a beard.
Great, that's that sorted.
What kind of girl are you going to go for?
Go for is not the correct terminology.
What is it, then? Recruit?
Find, I think, yeah. Find.
What kind of girl do you want to find?
Somebody who's funny and also got lovely taste in interiors.
Yeah.
Okay, top New Year's resolution, what do you think?
What's mine? Just to give less fucks. I just think care less about, like, other people's opinions. That's
good for you, Scarlett.
That's what my resolution is.
Big facts.
To give less fucks.
How would you eat, Maisie? You made any resolutions?
I mean, I'm that person every time that's like, oh, I'll go to the gym. And then I see how much it is, and I think I'll just go on a walk, and then look out the window and go, oh, I just won't. Just do it next year.
Katherine Ryan, have you made any resolutions?
Yes, I'm going to have fewer kids.
You've got one.
Yeah.
If she's watching this, she's nervous. Okay, let's get some answers.
Lose weight.
That's the right answer. Yes, the top New Year's resolution is to lose weight. Millions of people resolve to lose weight in the UK every year. Although, if the chief executive of Greggs is watching, don't worry, I think you'll be able to ride it out for a couple of days. OK, last question. Worst thing to do at the office Christmas party?
The boss.
Not if you do them well.
See, any other thoughts?
Is it to tell Susan from accounts that you find her incredibly irritating and overbearing, and I'm not surprised her husband left? If it weren't for her fit son who occasionally comes into the office, I would have left years ago.
That is a lot. What about you, Scarlett? What's the worst thing you've done at an office Christmas party?
Well, I was going to say don't shit yourself, but... Everyone shit the cell a bit when they're drunk, haven't they?
No.
Just try not to do it at a work Christmas party. Everyone's sharted, haven't they? Everyone.
If you've never sharted, you're not taking enough risks in your life.
Yeah.
Come on, live a little.
Last Christmas, I gave you my shots. The very next day, you washed them away.
This me.
Sorry. This me. Worst thing to do, office Christmas party. What have you?
Oh, I know.
Go on.
Is it grabbing the office Christmas tree, shoving up your ass, and screaming, "Who's the fairy now?"
Scarlett.
Insulting your boss.
Insult the boss is the right answer.
Oh, yes.
Yes, the worst thing to do at the office Christmas party is tell your boss what you really think of them. A popular tradition at the office Christmas party is kissing under the mistletoe. But be careful, it can lead to fingering under the boardroom table. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Rob's team have 2 points, Katherine's team are the winners with 4 points. Thanks to all our families, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.